The Commission on Elections' ongoing voter registration is not hitting its targets. The poll body is appealing to the public to register now, saying it's unlikely an extension will be granted. Let's get an update from ABS-CBN correspondent Karen De Guzman. Karen, good morning. What more can you tell us?
Good morning, Mike. With less than a month remaining before the voters' registration of the COMELEC ends, the Commission once again reiterated its call for qualified voters to avail the registration. According to the poll body, from December 12 to December 30 last year, only 60,000 registered for Sangguniang Kabataan. New registrants for the age bracket 18 to 30 years old top at 100,000, while regular applicants numbered at 25,000. It can be recalled that the Commission is targeting 1.5 to 2 million new voters by the end of the registration period. This is hoped to be achieved through the intensification of programs such as the Satellite Registration, Register Anywhere Project or RAP, and the Quad Media Presence. Meanwhile, some are already asking for an extension of the registration, but the COMELEC said that it's unlikely to be granted.
Tinaray ko ng pumila, sa sobrang haba, umuwi na lang ako. Kasi busy tayo sa hanap buhay. Kaya naghahanap buhay ako sa maga, sa gabi. Halos pumapasada ako kaya hindi ko na umasikaso. Sana ma-extend.
Sa Maguindanao po ako nakarehistro. Bago lang kami dito sa Maynila. Gusto ko sana mag-transfer, kaso nga lang, wala akong time sa kung umaga kasi nga gabi ako nagtitinda. Gusto ko sana ma-extend yung voters registration para makatransfer po ako dito.
Sana po ay masamantala po natin yung magkakampayan. Huwag po kayong maaasal po sa sabi-sabi na i-extend ng COMELEC. Eh, paano po hindi namin extend yung registration pagkatapos hindi kayo makapaboto ng barangay?
Mula po itong araw na ito hanggang January 31, hindi po kami magsasawang, magpaanyaya, magpaalala sa ating mga kababayan na pumunta na po sa ating mga registration sites.
The COMELEC also said that they are prepared to hold the barangay and Sangguniang Kabataan elections should the Supreme Court decide to set it on an earlier date. In addition, COMELEC Commissioner Ray Bulay, the commissioner in charge for the BSKE, said that all materials to be used for the 2023 polls were already delivered before the end of 2022. Mike?
All right, thank you for that update, Karen De Guzman. Philippine President Marcos Jr. officially begins today his highly anticipated state visit to China. The trip comes amid lingering maritime tensions between the two countries and a spiraling COVID crisis in Beijing. Our correspondent Katrina Domingo now joins us live from China to tell us what's on the agenda for the president today. Good morning, Kat.
Hi, Mike. Good morning from Beijing. That's right. As you mentioned earlier, a full-packed agenda for President Ferdinand Marcos today. He is set to meet three key Chinese officials this morning to try to settle disputes in the West Philippine Sea, as well as to try to settle the deadlock between the Philippines and China when it comes to the joint oil and gas exploration projects that were set aside or shelved several months ago, just before former President Rodrigo Duterte came down or stepped out from office or ended his term as president. Mike, first on the president's agenda at 11 a.m., he is set to meet Li Shanchu, the chairman of the of China's National People's Congress, which is kind of similar to the Philippine Congress or the legislative body here in China. Next, President Marcos will be meeting Chinese Premier Li Keqiang, and third, President Marcos late in the afternoon will have dinner with President Xi Jinping. Three key issues that we are watching out for today is first, as I mentioned earlier, on whether or not the Philippines can finally settle the deadlock when it comes to the joint oil and gas exploration project in the West Philippine Sea. If we recall, way back in 2018, during the administration of former President Rodrigo Duterte, the Philippines and China signed an agreement that establishes a joint steering committee. But that did not prosper because two survey vessels, had to be pulled out from the West Philippine Sea due to alleged harassment from Chinese vessels. Now, we will see later on if President Marcos can finally close that deal, also given the constitutional deadlock that the Philippines and China have been bickering about. Also on the president's agenda on whether or not the Philippines and China can finally come up with a COC, a code of conduct on the South China Sea that will guide activities in the disputed waters. And third, Mike, we're also waiting for figures on how much the president can take home in terms of investment pledges. We see a lot of opportunities here for those in the nickel business, given that China imports 70% of its nickel requirement from the Philippines. China also promising to import more durian from the Philippines, so a lot of agricultural players also looking out for that news. Mike.
All right, thank you for that update, Katrina Domingo from Beijing.